I am Stephanie Swanson, the issue chair of redistricting for the League of Women Voters of Texas. I am also a leader in the Fair Maps Texas Coalition. Today, I'll be testifying as a member of and on behalf of the League of Women Voters of Texas against SB6. We appreciate the opportunity to appear before you today. Thank you for allowing us to share the League of Women Voters' position on this bill. Let's start with time to assess the maps. This public hearing is being held a mere 2 to 3 days after publication of the draft congressional maps. The Fair Maps Texas Coalition, along with 40 community organizations, have sent a letter to the Senate Redistricting Committee objecting to this short timeline, or our organizations have not been given enough time to alert our communities and members about this hearing, let alone analyze the map to determine their potential impact and whether it is fair and abides by constitutional and federal law. This compressed timeline is also unfortunately overlapped with the Senate's final committee hearing for the Senate map proposal, which likely prevented public participation at that hearing. Again, we raise this issue as a major concern. Let's move on to constitutionality of the maps. There are genuine concerns about the constitutionality of these maps. Before we even get to the map and look at specific district lines, the numbers alone don't make sense. Simply put, gained two new congressional seats because of the increase in population that was driven primarily by people of color, particularly Hispanics. And yet those communities get less representation in this proposed map. This was accomplished by obvious patterns of packing and cracking of the Black, Latinx, and AAPI communities across the state, and numerous precinct splits have been made indicating that racial data was being used. For example, let's take a look at Harris County. According to the 2020 census, Harris County saw a 6.3% decrease in the white voting age population compared to a 3.7% increase in the Hispanic and Black voting age population. Yet the new congressional district drawn in this proposal, CD38, which is fully contained in the county, was drawn to have a white majority voting age population of 53.4%. Furthermore, it appears that as in previous cycles, there are patterns of packing and cracking of Black, Latinx, and AAPI communities across the county. In the current draft proposal, Congress members Sheila Jackson Lee and Al Green elected officials that were the preferred candidate of voters of color have been pitted against one another. Congress member Sylvia Garcia, another preferred candidate of choice, has been placed in the same district as Congress member Dan Crenshaw. The communities residing in these districts have worked hard over the past half century to gain representation, and it is shameful that the state is now trying to take away their preferred candidate of choice. How much time do I have left? Oh, okay. I'll reserve the rest of my time. I have I want to point out the historical significance of Congressional District 18, but it's written up, so thank you so much.
We appreciate the testimony and the League of Women Voters' involvement in our political redistricting process.